Yesterday, President Obama using children to drive home his message on gun control. The president said we have to do all we can to protect the kids.
I started getting a lot of letters from kids. Four of them are here today. Grant Fritz, Julia Stokes, Hina Ziha, and Tasia Good. They're pretty representative of some of the messages that I got. These are some pretty smart letters from some pretty smart young people.
But does the president's drone campaign go against this message? Well, all rise. The judge is here. Judge Andrew Napolitano, Fox News senior judicial analyst and author of many books, the most recent, Theodore and Woodrow. Listen, the president's...
On which Varney has to remind everybody that he's on page 276.
I know. I might as well admit it, too. I'm a little jealous I wasn't on 278, but we'll talk about that later. Listen, the president's drone campaign has killed so many innocent people.
All right, I'm looking at my BlackBerry because I want to give these numbers precisely. The numbers are from Stanford Law School and New York University Law School, hardly hotbeds of defense of the Second Amendment, and arguably intellectually honest researchers. The drone kills from June 2004 to September 2012. So this includes George W. Bush's drones as well as Barack Obama's. In Pakistan alone, killed between 2,500 and 3,300 people. Between 475 and 884 were civilians, and 176 were children. These are obviously innocent children. We know that two of these children were Americans. We also know the president never asked Congress to declare war on the government or the state in the area where these drones have gone. And we know that his new Secretary of Defense is in favor of fewer troops on the ground, and his new head of the CIA likes this drone program. So we have a president who has not hesitated to kill foreign innocent children or American innocent children when they are in a foreign country. He loses great credibility when he stands with innocent American children and says, I'm going to keep you safe.
What do you think?
I don't think the president's intention were to kill children. I think that the president...
Well, but Scott, hold on 1 second. We know that's not his intention, but if you go about this haphazardly, if you just drop bombs indiscriminately out the sky, that's what happens, isn't it? You hear that some guy's at a cafe in a crowded city, guess what? So are other people around that person.
Well, unfortunately, with any war, there's going to be collateral damage, and in this case, it's terrible that innocent people and children
are
killed.
But this is not, if I may, this is not a war. Pakistan is an ally. We haven't declared war on Pakistan. We have attempted surgically to remove people from a jurisdiction where we are friendly with the government. And in doing so, without authorization from the Congress, without a declaration of war, and in violation of the Constitution, he has killed Americans.
Here's the thing, Jedediah. I'm a fan of drones, to be quite frank with you, but the president seems so hypocritical trotting out these children. By the way, I hate that he even used their... I don't like that he used them in the first place, and I don't like that he put their names out there to the public. Be that as it may, doesn't it look somewhat hypocritical to talk about this? Our number one goal as humans, as adults, is to protect the children.
Of course it looks hypocritical. And my big question is, when it comes to these drones, where is the left? Why is the left not hypercritical of the president? If this was a Republican in the White House, the left would be absolutely outraged.
If I may, that is a great question. I remember asking Congressman Charlie Rangel about this, a classic liberal Democrat, who was furious that the president bombed Libya instead of asking the Congress for authorization to do so. He could have gotten a declaration of war. And he said to me, you know what? He's our guy. He does so many things that we like. These are a couple of gimmies. Gimmies? This is destroying the Constitution, and this is destroying innocent human life because he happens to be an acceptable liberal in other areas. You're going to zip your lip? Shame on them.
Yeah, well.